So I have to go back and remind you of what we were thinking of today, members. And, you know, my first thought process on this whole item is that do people really take voting seriously, or don't they take voting seriously anymore? 500,000 provisional ballots. If that, in fact, is what's happening in the state of Minnesota today, members, I would tell you that people just don't care about voting, or they would have registered in advance. You see, I believe in democracy, and legitimacy in voting is thinking and acting in advance. There would be little need for provisional ballots if people would actually take part in democracy, if they were part of what was going on, if they really cared about the process, if they learned about the candidates, if they were out there and really cared, they would register in advance. We wouldn't be worried about provisional balloting. You know, members, fact is that people need a photo ID for nearly every activity in life. And so thinking on that, I'm going to go to the Crawford decision and read a little quote from Justice Scalia. He said, "It is for state legislatures to weigh the costs and benefits of possible changes to their election codes, and their judgment must prevail unless it imposes a severe and unjustified overall burden upon the right to vote. If you can do nothing else in life without a photo ID, which you can't, and we know that, it is not a severe burden." So members, democracy is about participation. This bill ensures that all eligible voters are counted. There exists no burden beyond that which you need for your everyday life. There's no hurdles here. In fact, with this bill, I would contend that I, as a legitimate voter, I am assured that I'm not disenfranchised, because members, I feel disenfranchised today. If there's no way to verify voters out there, which we know there isn't, how can you catch voter fraud if there's no way to verify whether the vote was legitimate or not? My constituents did send me here. My constituents asked me to pass this constitutional amendment, so I am doing the work of my constituents. And as I look through this, for another thing Justice Scalia said, he said, "For the sake of clarity and finality, as well as adherence to precedent, I prefer to decide these cases on the grounds that the petitioner's premise is irrelevant and that the burden at issue is minimal and justified." Members, what we are talking about is a minimal, extremely minimal burden on voters. Nothing more than anyone would ask you to have in your pocket at the time you do most any type of transaction in life, and any premise that you bring other than that, due to this minimalistic thing we're asking for here, any premise is irrelevant and should be found irrelevant in a court challenge. Thank you, members.